Did you know that as much as 40% of the food in America gets sent to the landfill or dumped down the drain each year? That's 133 billion pounds. Part of the reason why is we throw away a lot of food that's actually still good to eat. So it begs the question, can I still eat this? Why do we throw away so much food? Well, it might have something to do with expiration dates. First off, the term expiration date is misleading. For many foods, these dates are just suggestions made by the manufacturer for when the food is at the peak quality, not when it's unsafe to eat. Except for infant formula, deli meats, and a few others, expiration dates have nothing to do with food poisoning. Stuff sealed in cans or other shelf-stable foods can stay safe for years, but for the stuff that is perishable, it's easy to tell if something's gone bad. If it smells or tastes weird, don't eat it. For other stuff, here's what's going on and how to handle it. Let's start with the easy stuff. These fruits might look a little gross, but they're still probably good to eat. Okay, maybe this one's best for some banana bread. So why are they soft? Because of enzymes. Enzymes are biochemical workhorses that make reactions possible by reducing the amount of energy needed to, well, react. In this case, they speed up the reaction that breaks down the cell walls in this mushy pear. As fruit ripens, enzymes turn part of the rigid plant cell walls into simple sugars like fructose. Meanwhile, other enzymes break down starch inside those cells to make even more of those simple sugars. What I'm trying to say is, the riper the fruit, the sweeter it is. So unless you see mold on it, or it's slimy, soft, ripe fruit is probably okay to eat. Okay, but why does it get brown? When the compounds in plants are exposed to air, like if you slice an apple or save half an avocado for later, oxidation reactions happen. An enzyme called polyphenol oxidase starts oxidizing polyphenols in the fruit, which turns those colorless molecules into brown-colored ones. Other oxidation reactions are happening as well, breaking down flavor molecules. So some overripe fruits and vegetables might not taste as good, but that doesn't mean they're bad for you. But what about this guy though? This guy you don't want to eat. The fuzzy stuff is mold, a type of fungus. Now, not all molds are bad. The molds in these cheeses are there on purpose, but generally, if your fruit or vegetables or bread are growing mold, get rid of them. And we're talking about that entire loaf here, not just that one slice with mold on it. The same thing goes for any cooked leftovers with mold. In hard cheeses, it's okay to cut the mold out, along with at least 1-inch chunk of the food around it. The reason you want to throw away moldy food is because the thread-like molds can penetrate deep into your food, like tree roots. Especially moist foods like breads or fruit, these strands can extend deep within. The problem with mold is some make chemicals called mycotoxins, compounds made by fungi that can harm us. Mycotoxins are behind the irritation from athlete's foot. More serious ones can attack the nervous system and other organs, or even cause cancer years down the road. While mycotoxins only come from certain molds under certain conditions, it's better to be safe than sorry. Now, when milk goes bad, that's because of bacteria. Some feed on the sugar lactose in milk, producing lactic acid as a byproduct. Acids have a sour taste, which is why your milk tastes sour now. Other bacteria break down fats and proteins into gross-tasting waste products. These bacteria are mostly harmless, and with pasteurization, there's little chance that anything bad is going to grow in store-bought milk. But it tastes pretty gross at this point, so it's best to check out sour milk. So follow safe cooking and storage guidelines, especially for meats. And if something looks or smells weird, don't eat it. Just don't worry too much if that banana's getting brown. What about other food? We can't cover everything in this video, so we left some helpful links in the doobly-doo below, including a neat app from scientists at Cornell and the USDA called FoodKeeper. It can tell you important stuff like whether that slice of pizza is still edible. Which, by the way, it's not. It's been in your fridge for like 2 weeks, dude. Get your life together. Who doesn't eat leftover pizza? Anyway, be sure to tune in next week for some really cool food tricks. And hey, thanks for watching.